Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
And now Mantra 16. Pushane karshe yama surya prajapatya vyuharasmin samuha tejo yate rupam kalyanatamam tate pajyami yo savaso purushaso hamasmi. Translation. O my Lord, O primeval philosopher, maintainer of the universe, O regulating principle, destination of the pure devotees, well-wisher of the progenitors of mankind, please remove the effulgence of your transcendental rays so that I can see your form of bliss. You are the eternal supreme personality of Godhead, like unto the sun, as am I. Purport. The sun and its rays are one and the same qualitatively. Similarly, the Lord and the living entities are one and the same in quality. The sun is one, but the molecules of the sun's rays are innumerable. The sun's rays constitute part of the sun, and the sun and its rays conjointly constitute the complete sun. Within the sun itself resides the sun god, and similarly, within the supreme spiritual planet, Goloka Vrindavan, from which the Brahma Jyoti effulgence is emanating, resides the eternal Lord, as verified by Brahma Samhita, chapter 5, verse 29. Cintamani prakara sadma sukalpa vriksha lakshavriteshu surabir abhipalayantam Lakshmi Sahasra Shata Sambrahma Sevyamanam Govindamari Purusham Tam Maham Bhajami. Which means, quote, I worship Govinda, the primeval Lord, the first progenitor who is tending the cows, fulfilling all desires in abodes filled with spiritual gems, surrounded by millions of wish-fulfilling trees, always served with great reverence and affection by hundreds of thousands of Lakshmis or goddesses of fortune. Unquote. The Brahma Jyoti is also described in Brahma Samhita, where it is said that the Brahma Jyoti is the rays emanating from the supreme spiritual planet, Goloka Vrindavan, just as the sun's rays emanate from the sun globe. Until one surpasses the glare of the Brahma Jyoti, he cannot receive information of the land of the Lord. Being blinded by the dazzling Brahma Jyoti, the impersonalist philosopher can neither realize the factual abode of the Lord nor his transcendental form. Limited by their poor fund of knowledge, such impersonalist thinkers cannot understand the all-blissful transcendental form of Lord Krishna. In this prayer, therefore, Sri Isopanisad petitions the Lord to remove the effulgent rays of the Brahma Jyoti so that the pure devotee can see his all-blissful, transcendental form. By realizing the impersonal Brahma Jyoti, one experiences the auspicious aspect of the Supreme. And by realizing the Paramatma, or the all-pervading feature of the Supreme, one experiences an even more auspicious enlightenment. By meeting the personality of Godhead himself, face to face, the devotee experiences the most auspicious feature of the Supreme. since he is addressed as the primeval philosopher and maintainer and well-wisher of the universe, the supreme truth cannot be considered impersonal. This is the verdict of Sri Isopanisad. The word Pushan, or maintainer, is especially significant, for although the Lord maintains all beings, he specifically maintains his devotees. After surpassing the impersonal Brahmajyoti and seeing the personal aspect of the Lord and his most auspicious eternal form, the devotee realizes the absolute truth in full. In Bhagavat Sandarbha, Srila Jiva Goswami states, quote, "The complete conception of the absolute truth is realized in the personality of Godhead because he is almighty and possesses full transcendental potencies. The full potency of the absolute truth is not realized in the Brahmajyoti. Therefore, Brahman realization is only partial realization of the personality of Godhead. O learned sages, the first letter of the word Bhagavan is twice significant. First, in the sense of one who fully maintains, and second, in the sense of guardian. The second letter, ga, means guide, leader, or creator. The letter va indicates that every being lives in him, and that he also lives in every being. In other words, the transcendental sound Bhagavan represents infinite knowledge, potency, energy, opulence, strength, and influence, all without a tinge of material inebriety." Unquote. The Lord fully maintains his unalloyed devotees, and he guides them progressively on the path of devotional perfection. As the leader of his devotees, he ultimately awards the desired results of devotional service by giving himself to them. The devotees of the Lord see the Lord face to face by the causeless mercy of the Lord. Thus the Lord helps his devotees reach the supermost spiritual planet, Goloka Vrindavan. Being the creator, he can bestow all necessary qualifications upon his devotee so that the devotee can ultimately reach him. The Lord is the cause of all causes, and since there is nothing that caused him, he is the original cause. Consequently, he enjoys his own self by manifesting his own internal potency. The external potency is not exactly manifested by himself, for he expands himself as the Purushas, and it is in these forms that he maintains the features of the material manifestation. By such expansions, he creates, maintains, and annihilates the cosmic manifestation. The living entities are also differentiated expansions of the Lord's Self, and because some of them desire to be lords and imitate the Supreme Lord, he allows them to enter into the cosmic creation with the option to fully utilize their propensity to lord it over nature. Due to the presence of his parts and parcels, the living entities, the entire phenomenal world is stirred into action and reaction. Thus, the living entities are given full facility to lord it over material nature. But the ultimate controller is the Lord Himself in His plenary feature as Paramatma, the Supersoul, which is one of the Purushas. Thus, there is a gulf of difference between the living entity, or Atma, and the controlling Lord, or Paramatma, the soul and the Supersoul. Paramatma is the controller, and Atma is the controlled. Therefore, they cannot exist on the same level. Because the Paramatma fully cooperates with the Atma, he is known as the constant companion of the living being. The all-pervading feature of the Lord, which exists in all circumstances of waking and sleeping, as well as in potential states, and from which the jiva shakti, or living force, is generated as both conditioned and liberated souls, is known as Brahman. Since the Lord is the origin of both Paramatma and Brahman, He is the origin of all living entities and all else that exists. One who knows this engages himself at once in the devotional service of the Lord. Such a pure and fully cognizant devotee of the Lord is fully attached to Him in heart and soul. And whenever such a devotee assembles with similar devotees, they have no engagement but the glorification of the Lord's transcendental activities. Those who are not as perfect as the pure devotees, and those who have realized only the Brahman or Paramatma features of the Lord, cannot appreciate the activities of the perfect devotees. The Lord always helps the pure devotees by imparting necessary knowledge within their hearts. Thus, by His special favor, all the darkness of ignorance is dissipated. The speculative philosophers and yogis cannot imagine this, because they more or less depend on their own strength. As stated in Katha Upanishad, the Lord can be known only by those whom He favors and not by anyone else. Such special favors are bestowed upon His pure devotees only. Sri Isopanishad thus points to the favor of the Lord, which is beyond the purview of the Brahma Jyoti.